Hi everyone, thought I'd do a quick video and explain what I'm doing throughout this video to create a personalised dog sculpture for one of my customers. First of all, I'm using normal tin foil and just rolling into a sausage shape. This will be the main body of the dog. As you can see, I'm just rolling it up into a sausage shape, which will be the torso of the dog. You can probably see now it resembles a dog sitting, and I will then just make sure that it's all compact so that it doesn't collapse. I use a couple of layers of tin foil just to bulk it out. Once I've got the shape, I then add some sellotape. This stops the clay from getting stuck to the tin foil. So if you need to remove any clay later on, you can do without having tin foil stuck inside the clay. I've already pre-mixed my clay for this dog sculpture, which was Sahara Fimo Soft along with white Fimo Soft. So I'll then just roll out some of this clay that I pre-mixed, and then I will add this around the tin foil. Here I'm just trimming off any excess clay and then making sure all of the tin foil is covered. Here I'm just rolling and smoothing out any of the creases so that you can't see where I've overlapped the clay. Okay, and now it's on to making the limbs. First thing I always make next after the torso are the feet and legs on the dog. So just making sure the clay is nice and soft and rolling out into a sausage shape until I've got the thickness that I like. Once I'm happy with the thickness, I'm then going to use my needle tool to create the paw detail. So just flattening the end with my finger and then creating the paws. As you can see, I'm pushing the needle tool in at the end and just creating three lines, which will be the paw, and then folding the clay over, which will create the knee and the hip. So just making sure that's the right shape and the right size for the sculpture I'm making, and then just trimming off any excess clay so I can attach it to the torso. Once I'm happy with the position, I will then use my tool to blend this into the torso. Okay, so now I'm working on the front paws or the front legs and just rolling out the clay to the same sort of thickness as the back legs. Using the same sort of technique as the back paws, I'll flatten the one end with my finger and adding the paw detail with my needle tool, creating three lines. Once I'm happy with the paw shape, I will then trim off any excess clay and add to the front of the torso. Here I'm just checking the sort of length that I need and how much to trim off to be able to add it to the torso. I'm using a toothpick to make some holes, as I will be inserting this into the front legs to keep the sculpture nice and sturdy, especially when baking, so it doesn't droop in the oven. So just being careful adding this into the leg. You can either make an incision or you can do what I'm doing and just insert down into the clay. I made a bit of an error here. The toothpick actually went through the clay. It's no big deal, just add a bit of clay, cover the hole up, and then you can attach this to the body. So just push the toothpick into the hole that you made earlier and then blend the leg into the torso. You may need to add bits of clay as you go along to cover up any gaps or indentations. Once both legs have been added, you then need to create a bit more of a chest on the dog. So by taking a bit of clay and flattening it out, I then add this to the chest area. Here I'm just pulling down a bit of clay which will go in between the top of the legs, which will just make everything blend really nice. So again, I'm just using one of my clay tools to blend in the piece that I've just added to the rest of the torso. To clean up the clay, I use a baby wipe. This is very good as it doesn't add much moisture to the clay, but does remove any dirt or dust that you may have added to it, especially when working with light coloured clay. So just blending in the chest piece to the rest of the body, making sure there's no lines or cracks showing. Once you have your body completed, I just get another toothpick and I add this to the neck area, which will help you when putting the head on of the sculpture and keep it in place. To keep the toothpick nice and secure, I use Fimo liquid. When it bakes, it will keep the toothpick securely in there. But you can use super glue as well if you wish. I'm just using a scrap piece of white clay, rolling it in my hands, and that gets rid of any dust or dirt that might collect in your hands and keeps your clay nice and clean. So now I'm just gonna roll out a bit of clay and make sure that it's the right size for my dog sculpture, for his head. Once I've got the right amount, just making sure it's the right size, I then add two indentations ready for the eyes. Just creating more of a doggy shaped face. Here are two previously made glass eyes that I painted. I will do a tutorial on how to make these eyes later on, but just adding these to the sculpture now, making sure they're in the right place. I then draw out roughly where the nose will be so that I can sculpt around it and make sure that I know where the nose is going to go, just to get the face placement right. And then I'm going to create the eyelids. So just rolling a tiny piece of clay together, like a very, very small hair-like shape. And then adding that to the top of the eyeball to create an eyelid effect. And once you've added the tops of both eyelids, you'll need to blend that into the rest of the clay. Here I'm adding the eyebrows, just to give the face a bit more depth. I'm blending that into the rest of the clay. Adding a crease so you can clearly see the eyelids, which just gives the dog a bit more character and adds a bit of cuteness, I think. So pinching off two bits of clay, roll these into balls and create teardrop shapes, which I'll then use to create the nose of the dog, or should I say the snout. So just make it kind of stick out more, a bit away from the face, before I add the nose. Once these bits have been added, just blend them into the clay, like so. And you can see already that this now looks more like a dog-shaped face. So just making the snout protrude away from the face a bit more. So once everything's been blended and you've got rid of all the creases, just marking out again where the nose is going to go before I roll up a little bit of black clay and just creating the mouth so I know where everything goes before I need to add more clay. So now I'm going to create the cute little ears for this dog, just rolling out some more clay, but not too thin, as the ears, I don't want the ears to be too fragile, so just keeping them at probably about 3 millimeter thickness. And then I'm going to use my craft knife to cut out the ear shapes before adding them to the dog. I'm doing all of this freehand. It doesn't need to be perfect, as you can always trim off any clay if you're not happy with the size or the shape. So once you're happy with where they're going to be placed, if you need to trim off any clay, you can do. I'm just using the ball tool here to create a bit of depth in the ear. Then blend the ear into the clay, making sure all sides are blended in. This will keep the ear nice and sturdy, especially for if you need to transport it via post. Just keep them a bit more sturdy and less likely to break. And there you go, there's the ears all done. Looking good. So now using a toothpick, I create a hole, as obviously he's going to need to be attached to his body. So once you've created the hole, you're going to use some Fimo liquid again, or super glue, not too much though, and just add to the hole, which will help grip the head to the body. But you will be blending it to the head as well using the clay, but this just keeps it extra secure. So once you're happy with the position of the head, you can then get some clay and flatten out with your fingers or with a rolling pin, whatever you prefer, and you're going to add this around the neck area so that you'll be attaching the head to the body. I'm starting off with the front piece, which will also be used as sort of like the chin as well. So I'll do this first and then I'll add the clay around the neck to make it all secure. But this will give a nice chin shape to the sculpture. So wrapping all of that round and then using my tool again to blend it all in, getting rid of all the creases. This will make the sculpture a lot more sturdy. I'm now creating another sausage shape, which will be his tail. This is removed later on in the video, just because the customer informed me that the dog used to sit on his tail, bless him, so you couldn't really see the tail. But if you do need to create a tail for your dog, especially a fluffy tail, this is how I create my tails. So just making some cuts with my craft knife, this will give you like a fur effect. Then you can attach to the body. Once you're happy with the shape, you can then blend the tail into the torso using your tool. Okay, now seeing as this is a Yorkshire Terrier, they're sort of like a golden colour with some grey on their backs. So I'm using grey clay, rolling it out flat, and I will use my pasta machine to roll out a lot flatter as I'm only adding colour. And then I'll be wrapping this around the dog sculpture and cutting out the bit that I need to create the colour. So just wrap this around the dog sculpture. Try and make sure that there's no air bubbles. And then I'm going to cut out the shape that I need around the dog. It looks a bit like a superhero at the minute with a cape on, but it will look good, I assure you. So using my craft knife, I'm going to cut out the shape that I need, cut away any excess bits that I don't need, and this will create a nice solid colour. I'm just using a knitting needle here to create some indentations so you can still clearly see where his legs are. And I will also be blending the grey clay onto the beige clay, just making sure that it's not raised up off the rest of the body, as you don't really want to see that you've added clay to it, if that makes sense. So this is the grey clay all blended in, and now we're ready to do the fur detail. First of all, I'm just adding some clay to the cheeks, as this dog has quite a lot of hair around the face. So to make it a bit easier for where his hair is around his face, I'm just adding extra bits of clay for me to then add the fur detail onto. looking a lot more like a doggy now. So just blending all of this in, and then I will get to adding the fur detail on. Taking a tiny piece of black clay, I'm going to add his little nose before doing the fur. So just rolling it into a ball shape and then cutting in half. And then once I've got the shape that I need, because all dog noses are different shapes, this little doggy has quite a rounded nose. So once I've got the shape that I like, I'll then add this to the face and create some nostrils using my needle tool. Okay, so now I'm starting the very lengthy task of adding the fur detail. This will take some time. So literally just picking off bits of clay, bits at a time, and rolling into small sausage shapes and adding one bit at a time. Always starting from the bottom and working your way up. Just using my needle tool as well to make sure that the fur is secured onto the rest of the body. Notice how I'm going in different directions, as you know, fur isn't perfect, a bit like my hair, so you just want to make sure that it's not all uniformed, that it, you know, does go different directions as fur would. Just make it a bit more realistic, and just make sure that you're blending it into the clay and covering up any bits where you've joined the fur to the rest of the body. So just working my way up the dog sculpture from the bottom to the top, making sure it's all blended in nicely. just working away around the legs, so the fur might be a little bit finer around the legs. This is what takes the time, but it will make a big difference to your sculpture. Just adding the fur around the face, again working from the bottom upwards and making sure that the fur goes in different directions. This Yorkshire Terrier had quite long hair, he was quite shaggy and cute, so I'm just making sure that I capture this in the sculpture for the customer. I'm just making sure that the fur is going in the right direction. This doggy's fur did kind of part in the middle where his eyebrows were. So just make sure that you're following the same kind of pattern and direction of the fur as the photo that you're working from. Adding even smaller pieces around the nose now, as you can see. Very, very fine pieces. And then using my needle tool and just scratching in some very fine fur detail on the paws. also just adding in some finer fur detail around the mouth and nose, and also the eyes. I'm now just going to add a bit of fur detail to his ears. Okay, so that's your doggy sculpture completed. Now to add on some of the colour, as obviously doggies have lots of different tones to their fur, and this little guy did have darker, a bit more tanned colour around his nose and eyes and ears. So I'm just adding this using some pastels. I prefer pastels over acrylic paint just because I don't like how shiny acrylic paint can be on sculptures. I just think it makes them look a little bit tacky, whereas pastels just give it a nice soft colour and blends in a lot nicer to the clay than paint does. Now I'm just adding some dark bits to where his mouth would be, just so you can see his little smile. And you can really see him coming to life now. I'll also add the same sort of dark colour around the eyes, and you will see just how much this really does finish off the sculpture. Okay, so this sculpture has now been baked. I'm now just going to add his name to the base for the customer, and then he'll be all completed. I'm using Fimo glaze to the nose to give him a nice, healthy, wet, shiny nose. And there you are, that's a Yorkshire Terrier, all hand sculpted by myself. And I hope these hints and tips have really helped you. This is just my own style of doing things. So if you would like to see any more of my tutorials, please see my Facebook page or YouTube, Cotswold Characters. Thanks for watching.